Hello and Namaste.
My name is Mr. Gautam Behra and today I'll be talking on energy required for electrolysis or energy consumed per unit time during electrolysis, and I'll be discussing on the voltage requirement for the electrolysis or voltage applied across the cell during electrolysis, and finally I'll be talking on current density during electrolysis. Okay. So first, what is the energy consumed per unit time during electrolysis or during electroweaning or during electrorefining? So energy consumed per unit time is equal to I into V. I stand for current and V stand for voltage. So this I and V, which is applied across the cell, right? So that means the energy consumed per unit time during electrolysis, that is electroweaning and electrorefining, is completely depend upon the current applied across the cell and the voltage obviously applied across the cell, right? But now the question is, in the industry, people always want that the energy consumption should be lower, right? To make the process economical, or we have to consume less energy during any process, right? So here, if we want to minimize the energy consumption during electrolysis, what we can do, right? So since the energy consumption per unit time depend upon current and voltage, so the point is we cannot do anything with the current, because if we minimize the current, then our metal production will be completely affected, right? Because we know, according to Faraday's laws of electrolysis, the amount of metal production is proportional to the current, or that is electricity supplied, right? So we cannot minimize the current, but we can do something so that we can minimize the voltage requirement, right? So voltage requirement, we can minimize it. So we'll see that how we can minimize the voltage. So another point is we can increase the current efficiency. So by two means we can decrease the energy consumption during electrolysis. The first point is by minimizing the voltage requirement, or that is voltage applied across the cell. And second one is by maximizing or increasing the current efficiency. Okay, so next is what is the voltage applied across the cell, or what is the voltage requirement for the electrolysis, for electroweaning and for electrorefining? So many people will be getting confused, right? Because see, a particular metal need a particular voltage to get deposited at the cathode, right? Or in the technical terms, we are calling as deposition voltage or decomposition voltage, right? But that is fixed. But that doesn't mean we'll apply that particular voltage across the cell to deposit that particular metal. The voltage requirement increases because due to various reason, because due to various drops of voltage across the cell, right? Okay, we may discuss it later. So let me tell you the formula. So what is the voltage requirement for the electrolysis, or voltage applied across the cell, or total voltage applied across the cell? So that is equal to sum of many voltages. So first is the voltage drops due to electrical resistance, right? Voltage drop due to electrical resistance offered by the electrical circuit, which includes the electrodes, cathode and anode, includes the contacts, it includes the bus bars, right? And second one is the voltage drop due to resistance offered by the electrolyte itself. Electrolyte sometimes obviously offers some resistance to the current. So there is a voltage drop there. And another one is the overvoltage, right? Overvoltage of cathode and anode. So that means sum of the overvoltage of cathode and anode. And finally, which is most important, that is decomposition voltage, right? Or that is the theoretical or that is the thermodynamic voltage required for overall cell reaction. So I can summarize this. So voltage applied across the cell, which is VA, is equal to, that is equal to VD plus VE plus VR plus VO. VD is the decomposition voltage, VR is the resistance offered by the electrolyte, and VE is the resistance offered by the electrical connections, or that is the electrical circuit, and VO is the overvoltage due to cathode and anode. And the next, we will discuss about the current density. So current density is basically current per unit area of the electrode surface is called current density. And this current density, this over voltage, this voltage drop due to electrical resistance and voltage drop due to electrolyte, right, all depends upon this current density. They're directly proportional. If current density increases, these things also increases. But the decomposition voltage is independent of the current density. It will not change. Okay. Thank you.